Hello everyone and welcome to a brand new video. It's Lindsay. I'm here with another unboxing today. I have for you another ThredUP 15 piece mixed jewelry box. This is another one that came from Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania recently. If you watched my last video, it was a pretty good box. So I'm excited to see what's in here. I'm going to go ahead and get started. If you're new to my channel, I'm a part-time reseller on Poshmark, The RealReal, and here on YouTube. I post content Mondays and Thursdays at 8 p.m. Eastern, but I also drop in bonus videos. So when you subscribe, make sure you also hit the bell notification for me. Go ahead and get this open, and we will take a first peek at the box. I will be offering items for sale throughout the video. If you see anything that you'd be interested in purchasing, just send an email to LINDSMCLARK@yahoo.com and I can get you out a PayPal invoice. I will need your mailing address if you've never purchased from me before. So this one was actually purchased on my birthday, which was July 29th. And I did get this before the price increase. So I paid $54 plus tax and $9.99 shipping. They do run $60 now plus tax and shipping. So here is a first look at everything. I am seeing some brand new on the card items, which is good. And Mechanicsburg does put everything into individual pouches, which is really nice. So let's go ahead and get started and take a look at everything. I'll either mention a price as we go, or I'll put a price on the screen if it's something I need to research. So first up, I think we have a necklace. And this is gold tone, and then it has like a piece of brown leather that's braided through. And this one is White House Black Market, which is a great jewelry brand. So it is like a collar length necklace, and then it does have some tiger's eye and rhinestones. Really beautiful piece. And I think they do use some natural stones or stone elements in the jewelry. So that is a great piece. Beautiful for fall. If you need a measurement on anything, let me know. But this one is definitely on the shorter side, so it would sit right at the collar. And you would wear the toggle to the front with the little charms. So that is really pretty. Let's do $10 on that one. And it's in very nice condition. So that is a good start. Just a little bit of minor scratching on it, but overall, very good shape. And next up is another branded necklace. And this is really pretty as well. It's got silver tone metal, and then they are outlined in little illusion stones, and it's a deep purple and like a gold color, faceted beads. Very pretty. And this one does have a lobster clasp with a small extender. And this one is 1928. So that is a beautiful piece, and it does have the 1928 little swirl pattern on the back. Let's do $8 on that one. That is another piece that would be absolutely beautiful for fall. I love that purple tone in there. So that's another great item. And next up is another branded piece. This is a matte gold tone leaf pendant. This one is showing a little bit of scratching on the pendant. There's a rhinestone there and a really dainty chain. And it is a long necklace. And this one is loft. So other than the minor scratching, it is in very good condition. We'll do $5 on the loft item. I'm glad that came in this box in the individual pouch because that would be an easy one to get tangled. So I'm definitely going to put that back with the clasp hanging out so we don't have an issue. Next up is a Chico's piece, and this is a mixed metal, like a matte silver and matte gold tone. There's the Chico's with the lobster clasp. And this one also has a long extender on it. So it is kind of a lariat style, so it does come down to this hoop. And then you have this long tassel. So it's a little bit thicker chain there, and then a second tassel on the bottom. So that is really nice. And it appears to be in really good condition. I'm not really seeing any wear or anything on the chain. So let's do $10 on that one as well. That is a great item. Oh, 4 for $4 on the branded pieces. And another necklace here. This one, I do not see a brand, but it has a stunning pendant on it. Almost looks like a heart there. I don't know if it's supposed to be that. And a black enamel. Really elegant looking. And I'm surprised this one doesn't have a maker listed on it. Definitely looks like it would be branded. But it is a gorgeous piece nonetheless. And I imagine this is just silver tone. Yep, it is slightly magnetic, so it could be plated. There may be a marking right here. Let me check that out. So this one just says made in China. It does not say a brand name on it. But I'm going to look into this one, and if I can find out any information on a brand, I will put that on the screen along with the price. But it is a beautiful piece. And now we're going to get into some of the earrings. These are a gold tone dangle, very ornate looking, and then the center is a rose, and these ones are signed. Let me take a look at the maker on this one. These are marked Barbosa, and I have a feeling that this is a really good brand. I believe I've seen Deborah from Timeless Jewel by Deborah open this brand before. So I'm definitely going to have to do some research on these, but they are beautiful and appear to be in really nice condition. So I will put some information on the screen, but I think that these are a high ticket item. I could be wrong, but that brand really sounds familiar. So I'm excited to look into those. And next we have some tassel earrings. These ones are also marked. They are a really pretty AB pink and then faceted pink down here with a rose gold metal. And these ones are signed. They are bobble bar. And it looks like they are in great condition. Let's do $6 on the bobble bar. Very nice. And next up, I'm not sure what this is. So I guess this is about the artist. It says, starting with images from my sketchbook, I transform a drawing into a sterling silver treasure. I'm satisfied if my final piece tells a story, touches your heart, or makes you smile. Mark Polin, handmade in California of sterling silver, polished with a jewelry cloth. So how sweet is that? And these are little dangle earrings, and it looks like they are a cat, or I don't know if that is supposed to be the little is that a raccoon or a squirrel? Maybe it's supposed to be that from the drawing, but they are really cute. And they do show a little bit of tarnish, but overall in great condition. They're really lightweight and extremely detailed for how tiny they are. So I will research those and put a price on the screen, but those are nice. And of course I will include the little paperwork with them. So what a great box so far. Next up, we have some hoop earrings, and these have like a sequin center. And I don't see a maker on these. They are like a brushed silver tone almost. And then the center is a blue gray. And no maker's mark on those ones. Let's do $6 on those as well. They are really pretty. Very nice for a holiday occasion. And next up we have some H&M. These are really large hoops with some plastic green discs. Green and white on gold tone. Those are super funky and cool. And they were originally $12.99. And it just says conscious choice. Let's do $6 on those. And these are Loft earrings that just came off of the card. And they're gold tone with an acrylic kind of tortoiseshell pattern. Super lightweight on those. I will include the card with it. $29.50 was the retail price. We'll do $6 on those. And now we're on to the bracelets. Next up is this really cute turtle cuff bracelet. And I don't know if that's possibly a real stone in there. It kind of looks like a Larimar. And then just a silver tone. And this one is stamped. Ooh, it is marked 925. And then there is a symbol of like a dolphin or a fish. So I'm going to test that. I will wait till the end of the video and test that along with the little critter earrings. But that is beautiful. So let's go ahead and get a size on that one. And I apologize for the siren. I feel like there's always a siren going on when I'm recording. That is sitting at a 7. And this one would go a bit larger, but it's not going to adjust smaller than the 7, I don't think. But that is super pretty. I love that. Really nicely made. So I imagine that is sterling, but I will test it to confirm. And next up we have like a gunmetal bracelet with black rhinestones. Very shiny. And I don't think there is a maker on this one. But it is really pretty. It does have a lobster clasp with an extender. So definitely a stunning bracelet. I'm going to put it all the way on the last hook and I'll measure it. So I did extend it all the way. It will go down to a size 8. And it looks like it's in really nice condition. Let's do 6 on that one as well. And next up, I have an Alex and Ani bracelet. And this one is really pretty with the clear rhinestone. And it is like a Rivoli cut on a gold tone. And this one appears to be in really good condition. It's an expandable bracelet. We'll do $5 on the Alex and Ani. And our last item, we have some rings. And these are all size 8, and they are like a matte silver tone. And you have multicolor rhinestones. There's a tiny red one, blue, pink, a purple, green, like a clear blue, and a black. And they're kind of made to be distressed looking. and I don't see a brand on those. But they were from Target originally. So let's do $5 on the set of rings. That would be fun for stacking. And they are really pretty. So what a great box. I am really excited to look into those Barbosa earrings. And before we turn off the video, I'm going to go ahead and quick test the two sterling pieces. So I'll be right back. All right, so we had the little critter earring. And I definitely think that is sterling from the way it's scratching. And then we had the gorgeous turtle bracelet. Hopefully I got a deep enough scratch there. So let's take a look at these two. All right, so here is the turtle, and then I re-scratched the earring because the top one was not coming in blue. I don't think I scratched it hard enough. It's starting to turn slightly blue, but the deeper scratch is blue. So I do believe those are sterling on both pieces. So that is fantastic. Let me get that cleaned up, and then we will recap everything. So this was an amazing box. We had the loft earrings, the gorgeous turtle cuff bracelet, these Barbosa earrings for three, four, we had the ring set, five, the Alex and Ani, six, one of the only unbranded pieces, the bracelet, seven with the adorable little critter earrings, eight with this stunning necklace, which I'm really surprised doesn't have a brand. Nine with the sequin hoop earrings. 10 with the H&M. 11 with the bobble bar. 12 with the really long Chico's tassel necklace. 13 with the beautiful 1928 necklace, 14 with the dainty loft necklace, and last up was our White House Black Market necklace. I'm really thrilled with this box. There was a nice variety of pieces, so I'm excited to research a couple things I need to. Let me know in the comments below what your favorite item was. Don't forget to send me an email if there's anything that you're interested in purchasing. And give this video a thumbs up on your way out. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you back soon with a brand new video. I hope you have a great day.